the river trip drawing, originally included in the 1964 edition of the Lydian chromatic concept, George Russell sets out to explain tonal gravity in picture form. Russell uses the chords of the song All the Things You Are, affixed to the bank of the Mississippi River and between tonic station towns, to show how the Lydian chromatic concept, or more particularly, tonal gravity, works. I don't think this drawing really explains the concept, and its lack of clear explanation instigates more questions than answers. For a start, one, why is Coleman Hawkins seen as Lydian vertical melody when he was part of the major minor tonality in jazz? Two, why is there no chord shown on the horizontal Lester Young line? Horizontal music, that is the major scale, still has chords that can be heard, yet these are not notated in. Three, the same goes for Coltrane's music. 4. What does supervertical TG melody mean? The lack of a volume 2 of the Lydian chromatic concept makes this definition difficult to visualise. Because of these problems in understanding the river trip drawing and the difficulty in making sense of explanations on the official Lydian chromatic concept website, I present my alternative version of the river trip. Our guide on this trip will be YouTube creator and all-round guru Adam Neely. I've chosen Neely as our guide because of his well-known status, and more particular because of his well-known dislike of contemporary Christian music.
I hate contemporary Christian music. I really, truly do.
Remember, this is my simplified view of the river trip. In World War II, a crack commando unit under the command of Major Adam Neely was being flown to an important military base. En route, their Dakota aircraft was shot down by a Japanese Zero fighter. Having crashed on a Pacific island guarded by a platoon of bloodthirsty Japanese soldiers, Neely orders his men into battle. Okay, so this is the situation. Major Adam Neely and his men are on this island, and they basically want to get here. This is Australia, right? And in Australia, they've got all these women. Now, these women are kind of attracting Neely and his men across, right? And each one of these islands, which I've actually put down as chords, right? A minor, D7, G7, so we're going 6, 2, 5, and then Australia becomes 1, or the tonic stations, right? Or in between the tonic station, obviously it's the same as the river trip. Now, the river trip, it was the river that was flowing, but here, I'm not the movement, right, of Neely, the major scale, i.e. major Neely, is these women being attracted to these women, right, moving from one to the other, to the other, to the other. So let's see, let's just have a look how it's going. So we're actually wanting to get there, but we can't get there because that's too big a jump. So we want to go from there to there to there to there. Okay, right, so Neely himself decides to set off out, so he gets on this boat here and sets off out for this island spying, okay? Okay, so Major Neely sets off for the first island in his boat. Neely ties up his boat and meets the local inhabitant. But there's a problem. She likes contemporary Christian music and listens to it all day long.
I hate contemporary Christian music. I really, truly do.
So after a slight disagreement over musical appreciation, Neely decides to move to the next island. But when he gets there, he finds the same thing. Everybody's listening to contemporary Christian music. So he moves to the next island, exactly the same thing. He doesn't actually get any rest until he gets to Australia, the tonic station. And then he's not getting any rest really, because they like contemporary Christian music there as well. Okay, so I'll try and explain what's just happened in that little story I've just told. Right, these chords in our major tonality, or we would say this is a 6 chord, wouldn't we? We'd say this is a 2, we'd say this is a 5, and we'd say this is a 1, all in C major, right? But, if we can just erase that. But George Russell doesn't see it like this. George Russell would see it like this. This chord, A minor 7, would actually be the sixth chord of C Lydian. This D minor would be chord 6 in F Lydian. As would this G7, which would be 2 in F Lydian. And then this 1 would be in C Lydian. Can read me writing. Now the thing is, for just to erase that, the thing is, the major scale, right, doesn't work on these chords, because according to George Russell, the major scale cannot produce chords. It can't even produce modes, it's just a scale, right? All modes are generated by the Lydian scale, as are all chords, right? Or some kind of Lydian scale. It doesn't have to be the perfect one. It could be augmented Lydian, all that kind of stuff. But the mid scale can't generate chords. So these chords are Lydian chords, if you're actually going to put them in. That's why you didn't put any chords in, because the major scale simply doesn't generate chords. It's just a basic the scale, as far as you're concerned. And these chords are like the background, which, I mean, you'll probably be saying this doesn't quite sound right, but I'm just telling you how he thinks. So what happens is, when the major scale goes along these chords, which are Lydian chords, remember, chords are all generated by Lydian scale, they don't match. So this is why you get these avoid notes. So the avoid notes I've actually indicated by nearly his hatred of contemporary Christian music actually ending up at an island and getting somebody who likes it. So you get this horrible dissonance between the two people, and that's what you get in the major scale, trying to play on these chords, right? So, like, the famous one is C. C, you can't play an F, it's an avoid note. But in Lydian, you can play the F sharp, because C Lydian has got an F sharp in, isn't it? So it goes together better. So that's basically the idea. The major scale, because it's going, if I can just write this in, because it's moving like this, nearly gets to that island, right? Remember, this is the major scale. And straight away, is in conflict with this woman, right, here, because she likes contemporary Christian music. So he's moved straight away to this island, and then he's in conflict with this woman, because she likes contemporary Christian music. So then he moves straight to this island, and he's got exactly the same problem. She likes contemporary Christian music. So then he goes to Australia, which is a tonic station, supposed to be. But really, if this is C major, you're still going to get the same problem, because you've got an F against the F, what wants to be an F sharp. So you've still got a problem here, even though he calls it a tonic station. But he don't put any chords in, remember. So he's saying that the major scale, let's call this G, so we're in G, and we're moving down to C. Right, so what's happening is, the movement is moving straight away. So Russell calls this progressive movement, right? We're moving straight away, we're not compatible with the chords, so the music's wanted to move on, wanted to get to a rest, which is basically this tonic station here with the C, which is Australia, where all these women are, right? Well, actually, if you look at it right by what he says, are still listening to contemporary Christian music, because they're not in the major scale. It still doesn't go with what the Lydian scale is actually saying. So I'm hoping I'm getting this across to you. This is how I see it anyway. So I'll just erase that. So looking at, let's just get rid of this horizontal plane, and now we'll have a look at Coleman Hawkins. We'll have a look at Coleman Hawkins and see why he does put chords in on Coleman Hawkins, even though Coleman Hawkins still played in the major tonality. I mean, Coleman Hawkins is like 1930s, 20s, 30s as well, isn't it? You know what I mean? Same as Lester Young. But we'll just alter this and I'll just change it over to vertical playing. Okay, so now we're looking at the music of Coleman Hawkins, which Russell calls vertical TG, tonal gravity melody, right? Now, we all know that Coleman Hawkins was really a major musician it was a major musician in jazz, but his main years was the 1920s, 30s and 40s, really. He was quite an influential player. But his main playing was always the major minor tonality. So why are we actually saying it could be Lydian? And Russell's actually wrote in the chords and put them down as Lydian, the Lydian scales of the chords. Well, the thing is, the way Coleman Hawkins plays, it does actually work. You can actually analyse it in a Lydian sort of way. So let's just carry on this story with Major Adam Neely, and you might be able to see why better. So Major Neely's still trying to get to Australia, and we're going to go to all these islands with all these women on. So he gets on the boat and he sets sail as he did before. Okay, so Major Neely sets off for the first island in his boat. Okay, so Neely arrives on the island. He meets the local inhabitants, who is again a contemporary Christian music lover. But this time, she hasn't got a record player, so she can't play her records, right? Now, Neely's got a record player. He's got a record player in the hold of his ship, right? But he's decided not to tell her, because he doesn't want to listen to this contemporary Christian music, so he keeps his mouth shut. But it's a problem now, isn't there? He wants to listen to his jazz music or whatever, and he can't do that either, because he's going to give away the fact that he's got a record player, and then he'll have to listen to contemporary Christian music, which he doesn't want to do. So he just keeps it quiet, right? And there's no music on the island, just doesn't listen to music at all, which isn't very nice for him, really. That means he's only doing limited things. So he wants to move, get out of it, and get to a place where he can play his music. So he moves to the next island, and we get the same thing. Goes to the next island, no record player. He didn't want to give his because they all listen to contemporary Christian music. And the same thing happens until we get down to Australia. Okay, so just to recap what's just happened there. Right, Neely leaves this island, right, goes to this island, A-7, meets this woman who's into contemporary Christian music, which he can't stand. So he leaves his record player. She hasn't got a record player, so she can't play the music. He leaves his record player in the hold of his ship, right, instead of giving it to her, because then he'd have to listen to it, and he didn't want to listen to it. But it means he can't listen to his own music. So he's playing around, he does things, I'm not going to play his golf, tennis or whatever. He does things that this island, A-7, is famous for. But then after a bit, he gets fed up, so he wants to move to another island for variation. So he moves to this island, D-7, right, and these might just something different, you know what I mean, and cycling and car racing and something else. But they're still contemporary Christian music lovers, so he still has to leave his phonograph on his boat, right, and they don't listen to any music. So after he's been playing cycling and he's been motor racing or whatever they do on this island, after a bit he leaves, right, wants a bit more variation. So he goes to this island where again they listen to contemporary Christian music, which he can't stand, so he has to leave his phonograph in the hold of the ship. And then he does the other things, what the island G7 does. So they might do, I don't know, tiddlywinks and play Ludo and whatever. So when he gets fed up with that, then he moves on again for more variation, and he gets stops at the tonic station here, which is obviously a restful place. So I don't know, lying on the beach, something he prefers to do. It's more relaxing, right? I don't know. It's not perfect, this explanation. I know. I'm just trying to do it as best I can. But basically, these chords, you can look at them as Lydian, because you're not actually in conflict. You're not actually playing the records, which is producing this contemporary Christian music, which is really horrible, right? We don't want to listen to this contemporary Christian music. Apologise, by the way, to people who are into contemporary Christian music. I'm just giving you Adam Neely's version of it. He don't want to hear this music, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to get us rid of our phonograph and not play it. Now, obviously, if you're playing in major scale, it means avoiding those notes that are going to cause any clash. So basically, all you're doing is you're playing around the chord tones, right? Not any extensions. So the music sounds all right, right? It's limited that you've only got these notes, you know, A, C, E, G, D, F, A, C, G, B, D, F. You know, you've got limited notes that you're playing around, so it gets a bit boring. That's why we want to move on. Because if you're playing A minor 7 all day, modal music, it gets boring, doesn't it? You know, I'm a big fan of not liking modal music myself, but... You know, so we move on to D minor 7, which is more variation. G, you know, you're still getting variation even if you're only playing around the chord tones, aren't you? So basically, that is Komonoka's music and why it can be analysed as Lydian, because you're playing notes that are perfect to the chords, but you're not playing as many notes as you would do if you were playing a proper scale in relation. So that's why this is called vertical TG melody. The music is locking into the chord in that we're not there's no clashes, but we want more variation. So really, if you're only just playing four notes and moving on to that, we have to move on to that one to get another different notes, and then move on to this one to get different notes to make the music more interesting, right? Now, in modal music, that is music that is just A minor 7 going forever, The way we get variation in that is not just by playing the notes of the modes, but different scales, don't we? You know what I mean? Modal music uses different scales to create variety. But in the Komonokians, we're just keeping around the basic arpeggios. So if we keep changing chords, we're getting more interesting. Hope I'm getting this across to you. I know it's a bit tricky. It took me ages thinking about this. I'm telling you, it's not something I've come up with straight away. I've had to really think about how I'm going to try and explain this. Okay, so that's Coleman Hawkins' music, right? So we're still in this situation, you see, of Neil and his men are attracted to women. I think this is a lot better than seeing a river where you're floating down, because you can see what's making the music move and why there's problems, you see. So the next person to look at is John Coltrane, isn't it? So we'll have a look at him now. Okay, so now we're looking at the music of John Coltrane, kind of. If you've looked at the analysis of giant steps in the Lydian chromatic concept, when Russell analyses it, he shows Coltrane plays both vertically and horizontally. But what I'm doing, I'm actually going to do this as kind of like a pseudo John Coltrane. The music is going to be completely vertical, no horizontal element at all, because I've already told you what the horizontal element is in Lester Young's style, right? So this is outgoing and ingoing vertical melody, right? Or this is like true Lydian chromatic concept playing, where you're using the Lydian scale and every resource you've got. So this is how I'm explaining it story-wise. Major Adam Neely is still on the island, but this time he's nominating one of his men to go to the next island. So this is Sergeant Lydian, I'm going to call him. He gets in the boat to set off for the first island. But this time, instead of just going with the boat and like a record player or whatever, he's decided to load the boat up with all sorts of stuff, because he thinks he might have to trade when he gets to the first island. I mean, we don't know who's going to be there. They could be, you know, nasty natives who want to chop your head off, you know. So he sets off with all this stuff on his boat for the first island, okay? Okay, so Sergeant Lydian arrives on the island with his boat full of all sorts of stuff, and the woman is playing contemporary Christian music as usual, but he's not as bad as Neely. He can listen to it, but he's not very keen on it. So what he does, he takes the boat, he says, oh, we've got all this stuff, let's get this radio. They put the radio on and they're playing some new kind of music, what they're picking up from Australia, which they both like. So they get rid of the contemporary Christian music stuff and they start playing this new music, which is coming out of the radio. So everybody's happy. So So we've got complete harmony on this island, and this Sergeant Lydian, he doesn't want to leave. He just wants to stay. Now, his job is to get to Australia, to tell Australians to send a plane or something to pick Neely and his men up from the island. But he won't leave now. He's quite happy with this woman. So, let's go back. So Neely, who's stuck on this island, right, with his men, he's now got a man here on this island, decides to send another man to find out what's happening here. So the next man, Mr. Lydian 2, Sergeant Lydian number 2, arrives at the island with Sergeant Lydian number 1, sees that he's really happy and he don't want to leave, so he commandeers the boat with all the stuff on and decides to go to the next island, right, see if he can get any luck trying to get to Australia. Okay, so Sergeant Lydian number 2 arrives at the second island, and basically they're playing contemporary Christian music as usual, and he says to the woman, "Look, I've got all this stuff in here," and she says, "Oh, a tuba! I've always wanted to play a tuba." He says, "Well, I play tuba. I'll show you how to play it." So they get rid of contemporary Christian music records and start playing tuba. So they're all happy, and complete harmony. Exists, and the Sergeant Lydian number 2 doesn't want to leave the island. He decides to top on the island with a woman, and so we have the same problem yet again. So Major Neely has got a Sergeant Lydian on this island, a Sergeant Lydian number 2 on this island, so he sends out another soldier, right, Sergeant Lydian number 3. He gets to this island, decides to stop here, as same as the other two. So he sends another one out, and the other one eventually gets to Australia. But as you can see, it takes quite a long time. Now, the way I've done this, with the actual sergeant stays on the island and not moving, it represents unity of the chord and the scale, right? Sergeant Lydian is basically the scale, and the woman, right, on the island is a chord, and in perfect unity. Now, the thing is, if this melody, right, I didn't put any chords in on this, because what happens is, depending on how you want to be, you can put different types of chords. So this doesn't have to be a straight A minor, it could be something else. So I'll just write the chords in. Okay, so we've still got tonic stations of G and C. This A minor 7 chord I've replaced with A minor 7 flat 5, which is now plus 4 of E-flat Lydian augmented. That's what I've decided to choose. The D minor 7, I've left it as chord 6 of F Lydian. This G7 flat 5, which was G7, is now plus 4 of D-flat Lydian auxiliary augmented, right? That's the scale. And I've left the C tonic at the end station as chord 1 of C Lydian. Now, the thing is, if you look, the actual root of the Lydian scale, right, which is the primary Lydian tonic, is all different. You've got E flat here, you've got F here, you've got D flat here, and you've got C here. They're all different. Now, if you remember, when we were using a horizontal scale, moving from here to here in one go, basically, we're using one scale, C major, sorry. Okay? But now, look, we're using all these different ones. You know what I mean? E-flat Lydian to F Lydian to D-flat Lydian in auxiliary augmented to C Lydian. Now, when you've got different chords like this, which are basically like expressing different keys, the music, the tonality is different. It's just all vertical tonality. So this kind of harmony, when it moves like this, is called successive. Ornette Coleman's Free Jazz, the last style of Lydian Chromatic, part of the Lydian Chromatic concept. And he's put A-flat Lydian Chromatic scale, supra-vertical TG melody, tonal gravity melody, ingoing and outgoing. So he's still saying there's some kind of tonal gravity, which I can't actually see myself, because of what he said in the end of the latest edition of the Lydian Chromatic Concert. I'll just show you. You can read it yourself. I'll just flash it up. he says, this is what he actually says about super vertical, I think. He said a third force, this is the super vertical force, I suppose, the neutralizing or reconciling force, also exists concurrently with the active and passive forces. The active is kind of like the major scale, and the passive is kind of like vertical stuff. Knowledge of the interaction between all these three forces are the causal and seminal forces involved in all manifestations on all levels of the cosmos has been passed down through the ages. Now, if this is a third force is a neutralizing force, then this a neutralizing force doesn't actually have any gravity, any pull anywhere. So it just wanders around, doesn't it? So it's just going to wander around, isn't it? You know what I mean? It's not. How's it getting from there to there? There's got to be some kind of gravity. But if you say it's a neutralizing force, it's a neutralizing force. It's not. You know what I mean? The neutralizing force in an atom is the part of the neutron, which has got no charge at all. You know what I mean? The electron's got a negative charge. The proton's got a positive charge, and the neutron's got a negative charge. Neutron's got no charge, so it's got no charge, no gravity, nothing kind of like pulling it. So how does it get from there to there? You know what I mean? What's it actually mean? So I'm just going to finish that. I'm going to let you have a think about that, because what I would have said was, I would have said that Adam Neely was on a... I'll just try and show you what I'd say. Okay, so this is what I was going to say, but he's saying that there's some kind of force. Neely's on the island, and he can't get off the island because there's all these Japanese. The two islands have been taken over by Japanese army and these Japanese ships. There's no way he's going to move. So what happens is somebody from a neutral country, let's say Brazil, and Neely says, can you send a message? Can you make your way to America and give a message to come and pick us up and tell us we're on this island? So the neutral guy wanders off, but he's in no hurry to deliver a message for the Americans because he's neutral. So he just wanders around wherever he wants. He don't actually know where he's going. You know what I mean? He's like fishing or whatever. So he's looking for the best fish, but he's not in any direct thing. But eventually he'll get to America. But it's kind of like wandering. That's how I see the super vertical. It's an actual music where you don't know what's happening. So he's sailing off, and it's not like a direct thing to that island. You know, I mean, he might be stopped by the Japanese and might say he can't go to that island, so he has to go to that island and stop him there. So he might have to go up here to another island to get some food or whatever. And then, you know what I mean? It's just, I don't really understand the super vertical myself, and Russell didn't explain it, and I can't understand what the people on the Lydian Chromatic Concept website are saying. They're just guessing as well, really. So I'm going to leave it at that. And I'll give you plenty to think about there, in those three, which is the most important, because really we want to be talking about tonal music. That's more important than this super vertical TG melody, because there's no volume 2 of the Lydian Chromatic Concept anyway. So if you want to use the Lydian Chromatic Concept to play this music, we don't really understand what Russell was actually going to say. To tell you the truth, I actually think this remember this River Trip drawing appeared in 1964, right? So this River Trip drawing actually started in 1964. And if you have a look in 1964, he's put the outgoing horizontal melody. So I'm supposed this is Ornette Coleman. Let's have a look. Coltrane, yeah, he's put Ornette there, look. But he's called it outgoing horizontal melody. So obviously no, a bit like this, but no tonic stations. So I don't really think he got it sussed out yet. Where you're gonna, how is he going to write this up? So he says he's putting it in volume 2 so he can think about it, but I don't think he really ever worked it out. So I would actually consider the Lydian Chromatic Concept for basic, for just tonal music. So that's the River Trip explained as best I can. So now we can concentrate. I've basically talked enough about tonal gravity, etc. So now we can actually talk about the scales themselves. God, it took a long time, hasn't it, to get to scales. But I wanted to give Russell a fair crack. Okay, so I'll see you in the next video. Bye.